Hello guys, Trudless here, and welcome back to another episode of World of Warcraft Leveling Legacy with me and the gnome Twinklebling. Twinkle little star, oh my god, you are so amazing star. That's a big rhyme. So we are here in New Tinkertown, as you can see here on the map, New Tinkertown, right next to where we were on our Dwarf Thunderhand in Morogh. And this is the entrance to the lost city of Gnomeregan. As you can see, there is radiation like bursting out from these vents here. And we are going to finish up the quests in here, in this episode here. So let's take a look at what is inside this house, because there seem to be some sort of quest dealing with the fallout. I guess it's not up here. It is outside, sorry about that. That marker he's outside. That's, I zoom in to see where this guy is. But here's Corporal Fizzwizzle. In the last one, we picked up these couple of quests here, by the way. You gotta clean up these geysers and recover the possessions of these gnomes that have turned into these puddles of green goo.
Pleased to meet you.
Tax Price Sprocket has a crazy theory about these toxic sludges being the last remnants of gnomes. So my men have orders not to engage them for now. However, the toxic airfield just south of us is teeming with living contamination. They are elementals composed of contaminated water and other toxic materials. Left unchecked, they'll overrun the town. Will you help us dispose of them? Yeah, let's dispose of these elementals. Let's get rid of them. Let's get rid of them. Do, 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 do. So, yeah, the gnomes. In the last episode, we did a lot of stuff with escaping Gnomeregan, and we apparently were some of the original inhabitants down there who had been stuck down there for a long while, as it seems like. And we're also quite a powerful, or not a powerful mage, but we are a mage in development, one could say. That's a new sitcom for you, mage in development. What a relief, thank you for your help. I hope the gadget in it, your grind spark was working on, helps the airfield clean up permanently.
Seen you.
Ooh, level 3, we learned Frost Nova now. Boom, worked like this. That's pretty nice. We also got a cloak, fallout cover. Let's put this on. Oh, the UI has bugged again, so I gotta put it on manually. Come on. Like this. I guess I need to reload the game, hang on. So it turns out that I was in combat and that was why I couldn't equip the thing. So I put it on fallout cover and everything is working smoothly. So let's take care of these toxic sludges that were once gnomes. As you can see, they have this helmet on. That's pretty terrifying. You've seen these guys in Hearthstone if you played the Naxxramas expansion, and we turned afflicted by some sort of toxic residue here. Deals 3 nature's damage every 3 seconds. Gross! Yeah, it's pretty gross. So yeah, we need to clear up these, and we also need to go into these geysers here of sludge to make the robot basically remove the green puddles here, the darker forms. He should do his work now, come on.
Initiating cleanup.
There we go. Thank you, Mr. Robot. I like the fact that he actually changes into this green model there. They add the sludge in his container. That's pretty nice. Pretty cool detail. So let's just make our way around this place using our magical abilities as a gnome, a mage. I really enjoy mage class. Back in the day, my friend had a mage as a main back in vanilla, and I remember playing a warrior, and we did a lot of PvP, and I couldn't really play mage back then because I was really terrible at staying out of range. I just loved going into melee and hitting things. Even with a hunter back then, I was a really noobish hunter. Huntard of all things, that was my bane back in the day. But now I tend to find that mage is a lot of fun because they can utilize a lot of strategies. Freezing people, they can have pets, they can teleport, and portals are the best thing in the world in World of Warcraft. It's so convenient, it makes the whole game so much less of a hassle. So that's why I really like to roll my mage as a main right now. And you've seen him in a couple of videos, like the add-on video I did and stuff like that. By the way, if you haven't seen those, then that's where I show you how to use the LVI that I have, and also to use the rest of the stuff, all of this good really stuff here. Yeah, we need one more of those puddles, don't we? These geysers, there's one over there. Even though it's not sprouting, I think we can remove this thing. There we go. the sludge is sprouting. And we should be, come on, we should be done now. There we go. I really like these quests in Gnomeregan. These weren't here previously. In vanilla, these the gnomes started out together with the dwarves, and they did the same quests. So the it made sense lore-wise, since the gnomes and the dwarves lived together in Ironforge, and the gnomes didn't really have that much lore back then. And it was further fleshed out during the later years. I remember back in Wrath of Lich King, we had this event where we had to retake Gnomeregan. But we failed again, and I think we progressed some amount down there, but we were... Oh, let's use the Frost Nova here. Boom! There we go. We progressed somewhere down there, but it was so full of radiation that I think we had to pull out once more, because it's... Yeah, you can see it's still oozing out there.
Pleased to meet you.
You picked this one up quickly. I can't wait to show you some of my other favorite tricks.
Very well, then.
I love the design of this staff here, the electro stuff, and it's a really early green item as well. The other races don't get green items this early, as you saw on my paladin and my dwarf and stuff, so that's pretty cool. Wow, I never expected it to work out, work on the first trial. Well, you've done that three times, man, so you're going on a roll now. We've succeeded. I wonder what other uses we can find for this little handy guy.
Off and away.
Yes, bye, Mr. G695, or whatever your name was. Hello.
Were you able to recover the belongings of any radiated gnomes?
I can't wait to give this new technology a try. You lost more gnomes to radiation than we can count. It's time to turn that around.
You have a great day now.
My brother has spent years working a cure for leper gnomes. Using his notes, I think I've been able... I prefer perfected a process of restoring gnomes who've devolved to sludge. So you can make them back. Turn them back into gnomes? Can we sit in this thing and do that? Oh.
Let's give this a try. Goggles, everyone!
I don't have any goggles. I need to turn around. There we go. So, why is he turning?
What? What happened to me? Absolutely amazing! We've done it! Sure, he's a little small, even by gnome standards, but he is all there. The real question is, what will he remember? Don't talk to me like I'm not here. All I know is I'm hungry and I need to get out of these hideous, smelly clothes.
Why did he get this armor?
Wait, come back. I have readings to take.
You didn't see a medic. Better make that a rocket scientist. Fucking... Oh, so dumb! I've never seen this before. It's freaking amazing. Oh my god. You're amazing, Doc. Oh, that was cool. Hello, Doc Cogspin.
Hi, how are you?
He's a priest. That's a gnome priest? Ah, that's a reference to Warhammer, if I've seen one. That's definitely a Warhammer reference right there. And also the back here on the holograms, I didn't mention that in a previous episode, that was a Star Trek reference as well, with the beam me out. Some forge guy. Let's talk to Spark Nuzzle.
Interesting.
The cataclysm tore open deep caves beneath Frostmane Hold, and troggs flooded out of their warrens. They succeeded in displacing the trolls who used to live here, and they stand to drive out those drive us out if you do not act.
Oh, he has another thing here down here as well.
Hi, Tinker. Mechatork hired the renowned demolitionists Jessup McCree to close the cave and stem the Trog advance. We received no words about whether he was able to stop the Trogs.
You left the factory setting on.
This guy started the event. Would you look for him at his camp near Frostmane Hole to the south beyond the toxic airfield? Yeah, sure we will. We'll go down there and take a look. I was really frightened by that. Ah. Termaplug has such a terrifying voice. It's really scary. So we need to head down south to Frostmane Hold. Now we know the Frostmane trolls from the Warcraft, from the Dwarves episodes, because those were the Drakkari, the Frost trolls that were doing a lot of stuff there. Okay, sorry I had to cut there. We need to go down further to Frostmane Hold. And the Frostmane, they were, I think they eat gnomes, really. I would imagine trolls being able to eat gnomes. Pretty juicy they look. Almost like chicken. Oh, sweet chicken. That's pretty silly to say. Is it cannibalism if a human eats a gnome? That's like one of the existential questions of Warcraft. Anyway, Jessup McCree, just demolition specialist, Mountain Movers Inc.
What can I do for
you? I won't be able to. It won't be tough to collapse the tunnel, but I'm gonna need my team and my equipment before I can get to the task.
Safe travel.
That was a terrible voice. It's gonna take a lot of power to collapse those caves. My voice, man. Oh my god. I don't know whether the damnable troggs understand that the storm is applies a kidnap a demolitionist, but the outcome's the same. Ain't gonna be able to blow nothing up until we've got the powder back. Go south to Frostman Hold and kill any other troggs you find. Any of them should be carrying the kegs of powder.
Off with you.
For a job like this, I know I'm gonna bling my whole crew of demolitionists, but with some help of setting up the powder, the charges and the rest of the gear, the job gets done a lot faster. Those blasted troggs have my men caged all around Frostman Hold. Now may have all alone without the personnel I need to finish the job. You look like a capable mage, though. Would you mind the demolitionists, the throg captures and break them out of their cages?
Watch your back.
We can sure do that, man. Here we have some of the trogs that were terrifying and oh, look at these cages, man. Those are scary cages. I wonder if the gnome could fit through those holes, though. Not sure how well these trogs are versed in gnome capture, because I think this guy could walk out of here. Seems pretty viable there, but oh well, let's hit this thing. Boom! That made the door open.
Finally someone who's not a trog!
Ooh, he ran into me. That's pretty cool. So, are those demolitionists? I believe they are working for the dwarf. And as you can see, these trogs, somehow they have these barrels with gunpowder on them that they stole from him. So yeah, they're keeping those around. I'm not sure of the intelligence level of trogs, but I think they are quite intelligent. Here we have some marauders, and what are the other ones? Are all the marauders? I think they are. Anyway, they steal these things and they walk around with these clubs made of these small skeleton heads. I wonder what those skeleton heads come from. Those designs have been around for ages, though. Back in vanilla, those were the rage in Skolomans and those good old dungeons. I really like the new animations for the gnomes, especially the females. I love their exaggerated facial expressions, and they look kind of like a Pixar character, in my opinion. I like the cartoonish look on the gnomes. Look at this face here. I was like taken right off of a Pixar movie.
Can I help you?
Yes, I'm finally free!
So yeah, female gnomes, I really like them. Even though they are kind of like hairy babies. Level 4. And we need one more keg and one more of the prisoners. Luckily we can get both now, I think. If we can get this guy before he runs away from our target range. Yes, we can. And we should be done right about now. And we are almost done with the starting area for the gnomes as well. And that's going to be a sad affair since we are, well, it's going to be, I'm going to miss this place here. New Tinkertown has some awesome quests, man. One of the best starting areas in my opinion. One of the best. Gilney is going to be fun as well.
Hi.
Hi. Get me explosives back. Well, did you recover my missing supplies? That's another voice for him. Well, now that's more like it. We may get around to blowing up something after all.
See you soon.
You have me at my own thanks and thanks for the men you rescued. I've already had the boys starting up the gear, get down inside the cave. Should be ready to go soon. My team has finished setting up the powder kegs and the detonator at the bottom of the cave. The cave in that western part of Frostman Hold. All you need to do is venture down there and activate the detonator. Detonator to explode the powder and collapse those tunnels. That'll stop the flow of troggs from the deepest parts of the earth. Mechatork will have an easier time of dealing with the remaining troggs if you take out their leader, who calls himself Bus Brugge. Good luck, Twinklebling!
Safe travels!
Yeah, let's go inside this hold. I think it's not much of a hold, it's more like a cave of sorts. It's gonna be fun to adventure down there. And afterwards we'll head to Ice Flow Lake, I believe, and Crushcog's Arsenal. Oh, did you see that? We went in the wrong place there. This cave is luckily super small, but these trogs here have mutated. They have these fungus on their heads. And we also see that they're taking care of the trolls. So yeah, trog is not to be messed with. It might be kind of confusing to a new player, though, if you have to deal with troggs and trolls at the same time. Maybe they think they're related because of the similarities in the name. Although they look kind of different, both are pretty primitive races, one must say, even though the trolls have been along for a very long time, and I can't wait to delve into the more deepest wretches of troll lore. That's going to be fun. We've done a lot of these alliance races now. I wanted to do gnome after dwarf because they start in the same area, so I wanted to finish this off. Next one is going to be more focused on... I think we're going to pick a horde race next time. Of course we are. We're going to take a pretty cool horde race. Oh, you're going to look forward to that, I bet. It's going to be fun. We started out as a horde character. And we're going to take another one on the ride. I mean, I've split this pretty much equally since we're going to do one race at each faction. Let's detonate this thing. We should probably get out of here, though, shouldn't we? How's this? Oh, it's a... That was the weakest explosion I've seen! Oh my god, no. Let's get out of here. They actually animated that. That's pretty cool. With the rocks there. Huh. I like that. I like that a lot. We have Great Father Architas. Wah, wall, boala, fools, ba, wall. He's talking Zandali. Zandali. Lokdim is there. Not sure why he was talking Zandali there, though. Maybe he wants to take revenge on us. Anyway, fell down there. We got a new spell. We got Fire Blast. Fire Blast is a really cool spell. And I like to put it here. Let's do that. Fire Blast will be replaced, though, when you change your specs into one of the main specs that you can choose from. It will change into Arcane Barrage, I believe, if you go Arcane, and it will change into Ice Lance if you go into Frost. That's basically the three different specs of the Mage, and I'll show you those later on when we get to level 10. Or if you don't play as this character, I'll show you when I do the summary video for the specs.
Great to meet you.
Jessup, how are you doing?
How are ya?
I couldn't feel explosion way up here. My boys did a fine job rigging up the blast, but I wouldn't have happened without your help. It's only fair that I split my contract payment with you for helping me finish the job.
You only got paid 50 silver, man. You were paid 1 silver originally, and we got 50 copper for that. You were underpaid.
Well, it's time to start packing up and moving to the next job. There's always something else to blow up out there. Somewhere in this mountain is moving, or a ghost is carving. I'll be there to do it. I don't suppose you'd do me one favor. Would you just take this report back to High Tinker Megatork and into your town? You'd need to know what the trolls won't be bothering his people again anytime soon. So yeah, we need to go back and be a messenger. Don't shoot me. And then we'll be progressing through this area. Velocity bracers, though. That's pretty nice. We got a couple of cloths here. Velocity bracers, apprentice robes, fallout cover. That's a pretty... Yeah, I guess that's from down in the depths of the irradiated Nomragon. And we also have some apprentice pants and the gloves. I do love the electro staff, as I said. I really think we should transmog this thing. Transmog, by the way, I haven't talked about transmog. We will eventually once I get to do more stuff with these guys, because we'll be able to change the appearance of the gear, even though that information will be quite outdated once Legion hits, though. And we all know that this Let's Play playthrough thing won't be done until before Legion. It will be done afterwards, that's a guarantee. So let's see what Mechatork has to say to us now, though. King of Gnomes!
Welcome, friend!
Welcome back, Twinklebling! The High Tinker reads Jessup's report. Splendid news! The troggs taken care of! We should be able to turn our attention to Crushcog's troublemaking. And our old enemy Thermoplug is doing his best to keep us from rebuilding and finishing our reclamation of the Nomragon. He sent one of his most loyal henchmen, Razlo Crushcog, and a force of raided gnomes to harry us. They've taken over an old arsenal up to the north, road to the north, and Crushcog's technicians are repairing those weapons. We have to stop them before they are able to get those mechano tanks back online. Go to Crushcog's arsenal and eliminate as many of the technicians as you can. I think we should do that. We also get another quest from Hinkles.
Salutations.
We've lost more than a couple of scouts trying to find out exactly where Razlo Crushcog's band will do with all mechano tanks. It's ready and the technicians are repairing.
We can't afford to take this, take it slowly anymore. We must act before Crushcog turns to his followers and his weapons on us. This techno grenade packs enough explosive power to destroy the mechano tanks and deny Crushcog their use. Take it north with you along the road to Crushcog's arsenal and take out those ranks. Oh no, sorry, take out those tanks. So yeah, this thing here is one of those mechano tanks, I believe. I think they look like this. Look like big giant. I guess they're not spiders because they have like four legs, but they're quadrupeds. Yeah, something like that. Look at this guy. He's moving explosives. Poor guy. He must have high insurance. Ooh, a leopard. Anyway, this thing here is the arsenal where they keep some sort of huge... I imagine they keep... maybe they keep airplanes and some sort of ships and tanks in there to make them safe from the cold. Or make them safe from the cold, I guess preserve them. So here we need to go back over to these tanks and throw some techno grenades on these things. I love that they're just regular grenades, but they're techno grenades because they're gnomish. So that's pretty cool. We do one-shot these guys though. I don't think you need to target... You need to target those other things because you can't destroy the big ones, you need to destroy the small ones. That's pretty nice to know. I think these mechs also count as... Yeah, they count as minions. They count as minions, you don't have to disregard them even though they are technically robots. Robots can be minions though, haha. okay, so we need to take care of 5 and 8 of these. So that's the last tank, and then we need 3 more of these battle suits. Oh, they're battle suits, they're not robots. There are minions inside them, I didn't realize. That was pretty cool. I think there are minions inside them, maybe? Probably. So if you played Hearthstone, with the expansion, the Gnomes versus Goblins, then you know these mechs by heart, because mechs, man, those were terrifying and so commonly used back in when this video was released, if you're watching this in the future. In the future. Man, yeah, mechs, pretty cool though. I think you can make some mechs. And to talk about the origin story of the gnomes, as I mentioned in the lore video, the mecha gnomes were the original progenitor race of the gnomes, and they were created by the Titan Keepers and were afflicted with the curse of flesh from the old gods. And then they turned into these fleshy little baby-looking gnomes. And they were super smart. The mecha gnomes were blessed by the Titan Keeper Mimiron, and you can see him in Ulduar, and he's pretty cool. And he talks like this guy because they have the same voice actor.
Hello there. How can I help you?
That should set back Crushcog's plan a bit, but we can't rest until he's defeated and Chill Breeze Valley is secure. So I guess that's the name of this valley here. Mechatoric will be pleased to hear that you ruined Crushcog's plans to use our old weapons for his followers. Without the Mechano tanks under his command, he'll be weak and vulnerable.
Daylight's burning.
And, Kelsey. While Hi Tinker Mechatoric, his military advisors and I have finally finalized the plans for the attack on Razlo Crushcog. I've sent my assistants ahead to Brunol Village to begin preparations. To get to Brunol Village, follow the road southeast of town. Once you ride, find Jarvi's Shadowstep and see if he needs any help. Our dwarven cousins have dispatched a cadre of mountaineers with Ironforge to join us in the fight against Crushcog. So this is the ultimate quest of the gnome starting area. We're going to take care of Jazlo. Let's call him Crushcog, that's easier. So we need to go here down to Ice Flow Lake and take care of this guy. I think it's a pretty fitting conclusion to this area as well. I do love the gnomes in the gnome starting area. Even though I don't have a gnome character actually in my roster of characters for World of Warcraft. I don't, and I feel like that's kind of embarrassing, to be honest, because I think they are kind of underrated. Well, they're so small they can't be overrated, right? Now here we have the infantry and some of the mountaineers.
Interesting.
Ah, yes, Kingsley, I told me as I expect you. There's still much to do before I can take on Crushcog.
We have reliable intelligence that Razlo Crushcog has taken up a defensive position on the island in the middle of a frozen lifeflow lake. To make matters worse, he has surrounded himself with a network of sentry bots that will detect any possible attackers. If we're to take on Crushcog, you'll need to take out those sentries. This device launches a dark, sticky paint that will coat the optical sensors of Crushcog's sentry bots. You should take out his early warning to systems. So we need to paint those sensors with paint. That's definitely a reference to some movie out there, I'm sure. To make stop sensors from being able to detect us. Maybe won't that really just set off the sentry though? Optical sensor malfunction detected. Shutting down. I guess they're just shutting down when they sensor something. That's good to know. I guess they were developed by gnomes, so the gnomes probably have some insight knowledge of how this technology works. So we only need to take care of five of these, luckily. We're shooting this paint here, or some sort of oil. Huh. Paintinator! The Paintinator 3000! Crushcog sentry bots. Yeah, that's pretty cool. So, paint is black. We gotta go back and turn this one in, and then we'll get the new quest to go further out on the island. As you can see, we have some banners from Iron Forge and Gnome Regan out there on the island. We also have some NPCs that we've met previously that have gone down there thanks to phasing.
Greetings.
You've given us the opening. We'll need to get drop on Crushcog. Excellent work, Twinklebling. Our cousins, the dwarves of Iron Forge, have agreed to help us in the battle against Razlo Crushcog. Mountaineer Strongrise veteran who knows the Morogh well. He and High Tinker Megatork stand ready on a small snow-covered island in the Razlo Lake to the north. Meet him up with them and let the High Tinker know when you're ready to face the traitor, Crushcog. Take this orbital targeting defense and use it during battle. It will help guide the High Tinker's special weapons.
Right.
Yeah, that's gonna be fun.
The finest words in the line.
Orbital targeting device. Point, shoot, destroy. Yeah, this thing is kinda awesome. If you couldn't tell. This is going to be fun. So here you can see we have High Tinker Megatork and his companion Stonegrind. On his ram there, utilizing the Mechano Strider, that's what they're called,
necessity,
right?
Necessity is the first cousin of invention.
Crash Shark is feet will send a powerful message to his master. Thermoplug, the gnomes and Omegan will not be stopped. Let's go. I'm ready.
Engineer Thermoplug refuses to acknowledge that his defeat is imminent. He has sent Razlo Crushcog to prevent us from rebuilding our beloved Gnomeregon.
Our
brave friend here has thwarted his plans at every turn. And now the dwarves of Ironforge stand with us. Let's send him crawling back to his master in defeat.
Hey, let's teach this little brain gnome a lesson.
Yeah, this guy, let's use the targeting defense system. As you can see, we can target a place on the ground. And then when these guys start to fight him, we can bomb his face.
You! How did you escape detection by my sentry bot? No matter. My guardians and I will make short work of you. To arms, men!
So in this quest, make sure you wait with using this thing because you can't really target him with this thing until you started this vent right here when he starts fighting them. Now we're gonna bombard him. There we go. I think he missed. Did he miss? That's pretty terrible. Let's use it again.
Megatork cannon.
You can also map it to key down here, that's a lot easier, so you can just use it on cooldown. I love the fact that he screams every move he uses, this is like an anime. As you can see, this guy is level ... which basically means that you can't really hit him because he's a high level character. So you need to use these guiding these missiles and stuff for him.
Megatork beam! Megatork ray!
And there we go! Megatork now he's almost cannon. Done! Oh, he should probably take care of those other guys.
attack.
There we go.
Missiles!
And he's almost down now. One more hit should do it.
Mech-attack.
And there we go.
Missiles!
We've done it. We are victorious. The Crushcog defeated. Thermoplug is sure to be quaking in his mechano tank. And rightly so. Your next, Thermoplug. You're next.
Oh yes, Thermoplug is next. And that's the event of Nomergon, the dungeon. Let's go turn in the quest with Down with Crushcog down here on the opposite side of the lake. That's a pretty cool quest line. I love the fact that they have actually voice acted some of that part. It's a pretty cool way of introducing players to the storyline. So if you're starting out World of Warcraft and don't really know which race you're going to pick, then the gnomes are do have a quite an interesting introductory storyline. Even though the story pretty much wraps up at the end of level 30, or some when you reach level 30. Let's talk to Jarvi, though. We're finally free of Razlo Crushcog and his interference. With the defeat of Crushcog and his forces, Thermoplug can't force any more of his followers to the surface. I can't wait for the day when we defeat him for good.
You have a great day now.
Ooh, level 6, fantastic. Some of the Mountaineers under Stonegrind's command were telling me about the situation out of Karanos. When the Troggs took over Frostmane Hall. Oh, event
no
here.
More. The people of Iron Forge and Oregon speak with one voice this day. Hear us well, Thermoplug. The day of your defeat approaches.
Man, I like this music. Oh, yeah. This feels awesome. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah. It sounds like the surviving trolls fled westward, deep into the heart of the dwarven homeland. Now they threaten the dwarven town of Karanos. It sounds like they're going to need all the help they can get. You should go to Karanos and introduce yourself to Captain Tharren. Just follow the road east, out of Runol, and keep going until you see the town. Now, we've done those quests on our dwarf, so I'm not going to do them again, but as you can see here, we have Frostmane Hold in the distance. And we have the exit to, it's on the opposite side of the lake, though. But down there, we did the quest up there with fetching the Shimmerweed and stuff like that. I think it was Shimmerweed. It must be. Anyway, that's all it for the gnomes starting quest lines. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I will see you guys in the next episode. If you did like this thing, then make sure to click the like button, or click the dislike button if you didn't, and if you didn't like the video, then please leave a comment as well explaining why you didn't, because that gives me more information on how to improve. That we like to improve stuff. And yeah, be sure to stick around for the next one. We're going to continue on our next character, and this next one will be a Horde character. So that's going to be fun. See you guys then, and I've been Crudeless, and you've been awesome. Take care, until next time.